Graduating from college is supposed to be that life-changing, career-starting moment that you look back at with a great deal of pride, right?
But for some Bay Area graduates, they look back only to see a mountain of debt, a worthless degree, and a headache they can't kick. In a special report tonight, ABC Action News reporter Ryan Ray shows us a new buyer beware story at a for-profit college.
Almost a decade after earning his bachelor's degree in internet technology, Daniel Malden is living a life of regret.
It changes everything for my life.
And his future wife, livid.
I am amazingly mad.
Malden's nightmare began in the early 2000s when he enrolled at the International Academy of Design and Technology in Tampa. He took out roughly 60 grand in student loans that, with interest, ballooned to over 160 grand.
We're fully accredited, is what they would say. Not really talking about the difference between nationally accredited and regionally accredited.
Oh, and what a difference there is. Their flashy brochure says it's a nationally accredited school. But here's something all students should know. State universities and community colleges are regionally accredited. Credits at nationally accredited schools typically won't transfer, and some degrees aren't even recognized by employers. Malden found out the hard way when he tried enrolling at USF for another degree.
And then they looked and they're like, no, none of your credits are transferable.
Now he's stuck with massive student loan payments, $1,600 a month, more than his house payment.
So once you're in that hole, there's virtually no way of digging yourself back out.
Student loan attorney Christy Arkovich says every week she meets new clients getting duped into taking out high interest loans that don't pay off in the end.
The degree's worthless, so they're never going to get the type of job with the type of income to pay back the money.
Malden is by far not the only student who wishes for a redo.
It adds up.
Web designer John Billicky hasn't bothered paying his six-figure debt because he says the school flat out lied to him.
I didn't receive anything, so I have no legitimate reason to pay for anything.
IADT eventually changed its name to Sanford Brown, but the company recently announced the closure of all its campuses. We did notice this on their website. Credits earned are unlikely to transfer. Malden is now taking his debt to bankruptcy court. His attorney filing suit this week, going after the loan servicer, Navient, to try to get some relief. U.S. Representative Kathy Castor is trying to give these students a voice, telling us in a statement, consumers and students should beware of online and for-profit colleges that use deceptive practices to prey on our neighbors. These fraudsters don't play by the rules. She's working to ensure people don't fall in the same trap as Malden, whose debt is preventing him from walking down the aisle.
It's a hard situation to be in, to finally find this person that you want to spend the rest of your life with, and then you can't because of like some BS reason.
And AIDT released a statement to ABC Action News saying it has very clear and readable disclosures. They say they always have career services available for current and former students.